All right, hope everybody's doing okay. I bought a used Jackson Racing supercharger for pretty cheap. Let's see if it was worth it. We're gonna crack it open, get everything apart, and see if I got my money's worth. All right, the very first step to getting your supercharger apart, and this is on a D-Series Jackson Racing, is let's get that fuel rail out, and we'll remove the 10 millimeter bolts holding it down. All right, now that we got the fuel rail off, you can see the four Allen head bolts exposed. Let's get that off and we'll be able to remove the intake manifold from the top of the charger. Okay, once you get those four 6 millimeter Allen heads off, we can lift the intake manifold off of the charger assembly. Okay, once you have the intake assembly off, just stick a screwdriver between here and pry that lip up and the whole assembly will come off. And then you can just rotate the vanes and see if anything's messed up in there or whatnot. And it doesn't look like it. It looks like everything is good, so I'm gonna take it apart and clean it and probably get a rebuild kit for it and go from there. All right, continuing on, you will drain the oil out of the supercharger, which is a 5 millimeter hex head. And that's the stinky oil that come out. And now we wanna remove all 10 of the cap bolts on the snout side where the belt goes. I already removed the pulley. It's regular left hand, right hand threads like normal. So just turn it to the left to get it off. It may be stuck, so you may have to hit it with a rubber mallet. Well, let's get these 10 housing bolts off, open it up and expose the rotors. Okay, when you get to this point, you remove all 10 millimeter bolts. They're all the same size, so don't worry about getting them mixed up. And you're gonna wanna pry in between here with two tools, flat tools, whether it be a scraper or whatnot, a putty knife. You have to apply equal force all the way around so you don't damage this snout, because these are nearing, you know, 25 years old and there's no parts left for them. So after that, you'll kind of wiggle it off and that'll be your snout. You take that and set it aside. This is your coupler. Plastic. This is the old style one. So we're gonna go ahead and get the charger assembly out, which is sealed here. So we'll have to break this out and then pull the entire rotor assembly out and look at it. All right, again, being careful to pry around the edges with some pry tools. You can go ahead and get the rotor assembly loose and it should slide right on out. All right, let me set the phone down and get this assembly out. All right, and there's a rotor assembly out. It actually looks very well. Maybe possibly even been rebuilt before. And the inside looks pretty good, so we'll wipe it down and see what we got. Okay, after removal of the rotor assembly, inspect the inside of the housing and the lobes. And as you can see, these ones still have the heat paint on them. So I would assume that these were replaced at least once in their lifetime. They're nice and shiny, so I probably will end up keeping this rotor assembly. Let's dig down deeper inside as well. We're at the snout, and you're gonna remove these four 6 millimeter hex head bolts. They are extremely tight again. Be careful not to break them. All right, with the snout removed, that leaves the two bearings that are pressed in on the inside and the internal case. So that's about it for breaking it down. Stay tuned for the next video for the rebuild. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.